You don't need Photoshop to do this. Few tools in Lightroom should be enough to get this look with a dynamic background. Watch the complete video for some handy tips and tricks to maximize the potential of Lightroom app. Here, I'll be using the mobile app. The tools used are very similar in Lightroom CC2. First, opening light menu to correct the initial exposure. Starting here by increasing shadows, which brightens the darker midtones. Then the blacks, which affects the darkest parts of the image. Darkening the highlights a bit. Also the whites. We'll add just a hint of exposure and contrast. Now moving to color menu and the HSS sliders in mix. Not touching the reds here. Reducing the saturation of oranges a bit, which affects the skin tones and the land in the background too. Increasing the luminance for more brightness. Moving the blue hues a bit towards cyans. Reducing its saturation too. Purple and magenta, will come back to them later. Coming back to color menu, adding a bit of vibrance. Going to detail menu. First, we'll use the masking slider with two fingers to get more edges for selection. Then increasing its sharpness. Now coming to the masking filters, where we will be doing some major edits to change the complexion of the image. First, I'm going to select subject. This uses AI on the cloud to select the subject, which works perfectly here. I'm going to long tap on this mask for more options. Here, choosing duplicate and invert mask to add one more mask on top of this. We have two masks now, one selection of the subject and the other for remaining areas. First, I will do edit on the original mask on the subject. Whatever edits you do from the menu on the right, it affects only the subject. For this, I'm gonna just add some clarity in the effects menu. I don't want the clarity on the face for now. So we'll tap on the plus or minus button and subtract the selection by adding a radial filter on the face. You can see the selection is off on the face now. So edits done for this mask doesn't affect the face. On to the second mask. We'll reduce the brightness by decreasing exposure. We'll subtract the selection by adding two radial filters around the horizon on either side of the subject, as I will be creating bright light spots here. We'll add one more mask of the subject and invert it, reducing exposure to further darken the background. We'll subtract the selection by adding linear filter at the bottom to get the brightness back there. We'll add couple of radial filters on the spots I mentioned before to create bright source of light there. Adding brightness to highlights and whites. Bit of contrast by reducing shadows and blacks. Adding warmer tones by increasing temperature and also adding orangish tones under color option. Dehazing a bit in effects menu for more haze. You can notice this affecting the parts on the subject too. So we'll subtract the selection by selecting the subject mask here so that the edits doesn't affect the subject. We'll add a couple of radial filters around the edges of the subject where I will create ambient light by adding brightness to the highlights. Some warmer tones in color menu and some haze in effects menu. We'll correct the brightness later if needed. Unmask on the subject and subtract to get only the selection of the head to darken that part a bit. We'll subtract the selection on the face with a radial filter to retain the brightness there. This may not look natural considering the light source is behind the subject, but just being artistic preference to keep the portrait face bright here. Adding a linear filter at the bottom to darken it a bit more. We'll make a couple of spots in the sky more dark by adding radial filters. This makes the sky look more natural. Subtracting the subject from the mask. There is a dark line on the horizon here, which I'm going to correct by adding a radial filter. Increasing the blacks. Dehazing it. Also adding temperature. Zooming in now, you see these weird colors on the edges, probably due to masking and the tuning we have done. We'll go to color mix and desaturate the purple and the magentas. Also here on the left, desaturation of the cyans and greens too to remove any odd colors here. Now we'll go to color grading. Here I'm going to add cooler tones on the shadows. Orangish tones to the midtones and greenish tones on the highlights. This affects the skin tone here, but that is the color grade I'm going for here. Making some corrections here, trying to tune the brightness on these masks. Tuning the curves to fine-tune the contrast for the final look. We'll correct the exposure on the face a bit by adding a radial filter. Also coming back to the earlier mask and correcting the subtracted radial mask to get the brightness back on the face. Tuning the feather to correct it. The final look here. Hope these tips were useful and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.